Okay, so in these videos, I'm going to show you some algorithms that you can use if you've got an agent that is goal-directed and is moving around in a search space. So you've got an agent which is in a state, such as state S here, the initial state, and it can take actions and it wants to try to achieve a goal. And in this search space, S is the initial state. Then there are states A, B, C, D, E, and F, which are intermediate states. And then there are states G1, G2, and G3. All of those are goal states. So what the agent is trying to do is it's trying to move through the search space to get into one of the goal states. And the way that it does that is by executing actions, and the actions are represented as directed arcs within the graph. So for example, if it's in the initial state S and it decides to execute this action, then it will enter state D. In doing that, it will have a cost associated with the action, and that cost associated with this particular action is 6 units. So it costs the agent 6 units to go from here to here. You'll notice that not all actions are reversible. So for example, if the agent decides to go from state S into A, then it can't directly go back from A into S. What I'm going to do in these videos is to show you some algorithms that you can use in order for the agents to determine a path or a plan between the start state and one of the goal states. I'm going to show you some algorithms that are informed, such as best first search and A star search, but I'm going to start with algorithms which are uninformed or kind of brute force search, and the simplest of these is called breadth first search. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to build a tree, and the tree is going to encode different paths that you can take through the search space. And what we're looking for is a path that leads from S eventually to a goal state. Once we find a goal state, then we know that there is a path that the agent can take to get to a goal. The purpose of breadth first search is that it's trying to find the very shortest path, not necessarily the least costly, but the very shortest path through the search space. So what it does is it searches all paths of length 1, then it searches all paths of length 2, and so on. And it does this by basically expanding the tree layer after layer. So it will expand everything at this layer before it moves down onto the next. So let's see how it works. So first of all, I start with a single node in the tree, the start state. And the first thing I do is examine it to see if it's the goal state. If it is, then I'm fine. I've got a plan, which is just stay where you are, no actions in it at all. But this particular state isn't the goal state, or isn't a goal state, so therefore I need to know where I can go to in one move, and that's called expanding a node. So in order to find where I can go to, I look at the search space. So from S, I can go to A, I can go to B, or I can go to D. So I'm going to put all of those into my tree like this, A, B, and D. And S has now been expanded, so I'll put a tick next to it. What I do now is that I will examine these nodes and, if necessary, expand them in the order that they came out of the search space. So I'm going to expand this one first, then this one, and then this one. If any of them are the goal state, then I've finished. So the first one I'll examine is A. I'll say to myself, is it the goal state? No, it's not. So I need to expand it. So where can I go to from A in a single action? Well, I can go to B, or I can go to G1. So I'll put those into the tree, like so, and I'll say that that node is expanded. Now you'll notice that G1 is a goal node, but I don't accept it at this point as being the shortest path. And the reason for that is that I haven't looked at these yet. Either of those might be the goal state, it's just that I haven't looked at them yet. So therefore, I'm not going to accept that as the shortest path, not yet anyway. I need to look at these first. So the next thing that I do is I look at node B. And I say to myself, is it the goal state? Well, no, it's not. So let's see where I can get to in a single step from B. Well, I can go to state A, or I can go to state C. So I'll put those into the tree. Now you notice here that node A has already been visited and expanded. So you might think it'd be a good idea if I didn't put it into the tree again. Why would I want to? And in fact, you're quite right. It isn't a particularly good idea to put it in again. But breadth first search is in fact a very robust algorithm, and it doesn't matter if you put it in again, it will still find the answer for you. So I'm going to put it in again. So what I next do, that one is now visited, what I next do is I look at state D, ask if it's the goal state, no it's not, and ask myself where can I go to in a single step. Well, I can go to C, to E, and I can also go back to S. So a similar comment applies. I could in fact not go back to S here, but breadth first search doesn't mind. So I'll put them all in here and say that D is now visited. So I've now visited all paths of length one. So what I now do is I start systematically looking at all the paths of length two. So in other words, I'm going to go across here. So I'm going to think of this like my to-do list or agenda. So the first thing that I have to do is to look at node B. I'm doing the simplest version of breadth first search. So therefore, I'm not going to worry that it's already been visited. I'm going to do it again. So I'm going to do a bit of extra work. So B, from B, I can go to A and C. So I'll put those into the tree here and say that node is visited. And then I get to this node. This node is a goal state. So at this point, I can stop the algorithm and declare that that's the goal. The next thing that I need to do is I need to work out what the path is that leads to that goal. And the way that I do is that I trace this back to its parent and back to its parent all the way up. So the path that the agent needs to follow is from S, it needs to go to state A, and from A, it needs to go to state G1. And that achieves the goal, and it achieves the goal in the fewest steps possible. And we know that because we explored all paths of length 1 before we started exploring the paths of length 2.